he is at his own mercy. But when a person lives in a way that he wants to reach out to others, his maker will reach out to him because he has reached out to those who have been created by the same maker. Subhanallah. So my brothers and sisters, my message today is it is about time we reached out to others with the goodness that Allah has given us. If Allah has given you power, use that power to help people, not to harm people. If Allah has given you wealth, go out and look for those who are in need. Many times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us that the people who are in dire need, sometimes you will not recognize them because they are too shy to ask you. يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفِ. A person who is ignorant may look at the poor and consider them rich because the poor are not going out to beg. There are two types of poor. Those who have the guts to go out and beg, they must be in a serious condition. May Allah protect us from begging. But those who are in greater need, sometimes they are too shy to beg because they call out to Allah alone. So it is up to me and you to make dua to Allah, to ask Allah, supplicate to Allah, "Oh Allah, I have a little bit of wealth. Show me those who are in most need so that I can use my wealth spending on those who are going to worship you. On those whom when we make life easy for them, they will pray to you and they will pray for me as well." Sometimes you help a man, he is not grateful. But sometimes you give them small assistance, they pray for you so much that you do not know your good health is as a result of the prayer of someone whom you've helped somewhere down the line. May Allah use us to reach out to one another. My visit to this beautiful country of Nigeria is also connected to the fact that I felt I needed to meet my brothers and sisters. And I needed to share the good message of the deen. We have a religion of peace. We promote tolerance. We promote goodness. We promote peace. And we promote assisting one another, reaching out even to those who do not share the same belief. Because it is through reaching out to them in goodness that they will see the light of this beautiful deen and they will inch towards it, if not convert completely into it. May Allah make us steadfast and strong. So my brothers and sisters, if you have been given a little bit of wealth by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask yourself, have I reached out to any poor community around my own country to drill a well, to drill a few boreholes in a way that when I die, they will still be extracting the water and I will be receiving the full reward of everything they are achieving and of all the goodness they get. What did I use my wealth for? Or I ask myself, have I reached out to the homeless and built one room house for one person somewhere in the rural areas of my own country? If Allah has given me the wealth and I choose some poor person, some poor family somewhere far away, and I have built just quietly one home with one room, not something very fancy. You know, in our countries of Africa, the deeper you go into the rural areas, the cheaper it becomes to build. I'm sure it is the same here. So if we go deep in and we can house two or three families quietly between us and Allah, by the will of Allah, He will help us to build that house we need in paradise. May Allah grant us Jannah. Sometimes we lack ideas, but we have a lot of wealth. And sometimes we have a lot of wealth, but because we are eyeing out another property, another car, another gadget, we forget to become charitable, my brothers and sisters. Sometimes a man has millions, and instead of reaching out to people, he is looking at another building which requires more millions. So he is just amassing and amassing. My brothers and sisters, there is no harm in investing. There is no harm in building whatever you can in terms of the dunya. But remember to build your paradise by helping one another. When you reach out to the creatures of Allah, to the fellow human beings, to the Muslimin, and on top of that to your own relatives who might be poor, when you reach out to them in a good way, when you make life easy for them, when you pay school fees for their children, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will definitely reach out to you in so many ways. You will have good health, you will have good children, you will have children who may get good results, and you will have people, children who will be the coolness of your eyes. Why? Because you reached out to help the children of others, so Allah took care of your own children in the process. Let us not be shallow-minded. This is only one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine reaching out to people. How many of us have reached out to people in order to distribute some form of knowledge? Nowadays you have USB sticks. You can purchase 20 of them. It won't cost you much. You can load them with some good Islamic literature, whether it is audio, whether it is books, whether it is video, and you can distribute them and give them to people who will make use of them, even if it is in the form of a DVD or an audio CD or whatever else it is that is reaching out to our brothers and sisters in order to disseminate and teach the correct Islamic teachings. That is also helping your brothers and sisters. So this religion is so pure that we are sitting here in the house of the Almighty talking about how to reach out to others in a positive way. Now my brothers and sisters, imagine someone who is harming others. If benefiting people will call the help of Allah for ourselves, what do you think harming people will do? So this is why we are taught that if you cannot benefit others, the minimum, do not harm them. If you have not harmed someone, you have already benefited them through the fact that you did not harm them. Amazing. Subhanallah. But that is the bare minimum. However, in order to help people, you will need to know people. In order to know the people, Allah has made the 5 salah compulsory and He has asked you to come to the masjid. Why did He ask you to come to the masjid? So that you can meet one another, so that you can know one another, so that you can talk to one another, so that you can help one another. Subhanallah. Today, I guarantee you, we are seated in the masjid. If you look at the brothers sitting on either side of you, you will not know each other in most cases. You will not know who this is. And they will not know who you are. What we know, we are brothers indeed. But it needs to go more than that. We need to love one another for the sake of Allah. When you come for Salatul Asr or Fajr or whatever other salah it is, try to learn to greet the people as you are entering the masjid, as you are exiting the masjid. And it should not be such that we make life difficult for others by making it hard for them to come to the house of Allah. When we look at them, we beg from them. My brother, you are the boss of that company. I need a job at that company. He will tell you, brother, I have come here to worship Allah. Don't make it hard for me. Do not make it hard for me to come to the house of Allah. If everyone is going to beg for me a job, how am I going to enter the house of Allah? I am here without my title. My brothers and sisters, the beauty of Islam. When you walk into the masjid, your title remains with your shoes outside. Do you know that? You can be Brigadier General. That was outside the masjid. Inside, you are my brother in Islam. That is the highest title you can have. I can be who I want. I can be the top shot, the biggest businessman, the richest man, whoever I want. When I enter the house of Allah, my title stays outside the door, because I come here, there is no superiority.